Yo, what up? You checking out Your World Is Oz. You can check me out on whoisLukeJames.com. You can at me on Twitter, at whoisLukeJames.com. You can Google me, Who Is Luke James. I'm there. You dig? Your World Is Oz.
It's crazy how your heart just has a mind of its own. Yeah, yeah. Like when a smile that makes the choice on its own.
Mm-hmm. Yo, what up? This is Luke James. You're checking out Cool Beans.
Your World Is Oz.
How I got started. Basically, man, I was in a group with two of my brothers in New Orleans. After a gig, we decided to go to the Singer Theater where Ryan McKnight featuring Tyrese was performing. Decided to sit on outside of the back entrance and just start singing, hoping that somebody would notice us. By doing that, Frank Gatson, who was Tyrese's manager at the time, noticed us. We moved to LA, we started doing background for Tyrese. Later in the year, me and one of my brothers, we wound up getting signed to J Records, Luke and Q. After that, I started writing, just started developing my sound, and through that, I met Danger. Yeah, we got cool and we just started making music, man. And then I met a bunch of other cats, man. Kittis and Sean, who did I Want You with me.
Yeah,
Nazri and Adam, who did Angel with me. And just like that, man, connections through writing, so.
That's deep, right?
God is good.
I know you guys are here, but I'm also right now, as we speak, performing on the BET Honors. I had the pleasure of doing that and singing in front of the First Lady and Maya Angelou and Spike Lee and all those beautiful people. So I'm blessed, man. I'm super grateful and I thank y'all.
So, man, I'm honored. Man, I'm super grateful. This is something I've been dreaming of all my life, you know? And to finally have a shot like that in front of those people was amazing. It's kind of a blur. I kind of blacked out on it, you know.
How's the performance?
Oh man, I you know what? I can't really say, man. I remember stepping out on stage, and I remember telling myself everything's gonna be all right. I was just elated, man. It was amazing, you know. The reaction that I got, people that have never seen me before, never heard this song, didn't owe me anything, and you know they weren't paid to get up and clap. So it was amazing, man. It was an amazing feeling. To get all those accolades from those types of people. Yeah. You know, I get my inspiration just living, man. Life, just being around other lives, other people. I was brought up on the greats, you know, and knowing what the classic and soulful is, you know, being honest in music. So, you know, of course, Marvin Gaye and Al Green and Otis Redding and Sam Cooke, Reba McEntire, everything, Sinead O'Connor. My mother didn't, you know, she didn't keep me away from that type of music. I wasn't really into hip hop, like talking about the closest I got to hip hop was D'Angelo. So all I want to do, again, like I said, is inspire somebody to be whoever, whether it's to be a garbage man, if that's what you dream of being. You know what I mean? I just want to inspire like other people have inspired me. You know, I feel like music works for everyone. Music is everything. So I hope to be that thing that inspires someone to say, I want to be a dentist. Or, you know, I was listening to this and this kind of got me focused or gave me a feeling. Oh, I want to be in love. Man, all I want to do is bring honesty to it. You know, I just want to stay true to myself and be honest on stage and honest in my records.
Well, the funny thing about this heart of mine, it knows what it wants. But see, the crazy thing is my mind tries to deny it. But girl, I can't fight with.
I can say you gotta have a mindset, work hard to work harder. It's life, that's what life is about. You can't get in your own way. You know, don't let anyone else get in your way. You know what you want, you go for it. You set your mind to it, and that is it. There's no B, there's A. You just gotta stay prayed up, man, and just focus. We all gonna die.
Yeah.
It's inevitable. You have to take every day as if it is your last, every second. I'm human, so I have moments where I'm just like impatient, upset about whatever this particular situation is. But then when I stop and think, of course, I'm just grateful because I could be somewhere else. I could be outside freezing right now. I could be sitting at home in New Orleans waiting for this shot, waiting for cats like you to give me an interview. So, and that's all God, man. That's all things that I've learned, how to just stay humble.
Yeah.